Hello and hi to my new video. Every time when I sit at the table, most of the time I do puzzles. Yes, and we do a puzzle. I want to do a little more piece count this time. And I have there a new one. I have bought it with the other Castorland, the bicycle, the 500 pieces, and now we have a still life with 1,500 pieces. I didn't notice the brands, and I have a really obsession with still lifes. I love them. I really love them and like them. And I think it's a photo, but it can't also be a drawing. The window outside and the teas set up and the sugar. Little sugar. I don't know. Oh! Yes, and I want a puzzle with a higher piece count, because I would like to do more. Sometimes I would like to do a puzzle with 1,500, 2,000, 3,000 pieces. 3,000 pieces is on this table. It fits on its table. Larger I can't go. So I usually buy thousands, 2,000, 3,000, and sometimes I think I didn't have one with 1,500 pieces, because I never saw one. It's so seldom. And now I see that's really small. And I thought the puzzle size would be like this. This is their normal size, so a little bit on the smaller size, but normal size. let's open this. The pieces are really, really small. There are so small pieces. They have the same count of pieces, the same cardboard. It's really sturdy. The same variants. Variants. I don't know how to pronounce this. You have all sorts of shapes like here, but the pieces they're halfway smaller. Whoa, that's really nice. I'd never have this brand, and I have bought it on an internet site named Puzzle.at, and I thought they're really cheap, they're nice pictures, and I'd like to have new brands. They're, I think, from Poland. Yeah, Poland, PL. Yeah, made in Poland. Here is it. But the pieces are really small. I never have seen a big count puzzle with really, really small pieces. Maybe if I have one with a 1,000 piece count, there were the piece shapes, the pieces were in between the 500 and the 1,500. And it's, they're really, really small. They are so tiny. But they are really lovely pieces. They are really, really, really sturdy. You can't bend it. They are really sturdy. And they have all varieties. Nothing stick together. Almost nothing puzzle dust. It's such a... No, such a such a nice quality for so low money, and this is really, really, really funny. So small pieces, like mini pieces. And you can have in one hand many, many pieces. Yes. But I will puzzle this, although their pieces are really, really small. It has 5,500 pieces, and you can the same amount of space on the table, you can draw more pieces and lay a lot. That's so funny. I always seem to dislike sorting. I didn't like it. No, really not. But with larger piece amounts, you have always the problem that you can't do this much pieces, laying that upside and bright it all out. It's perhaps because the pieces are so small, you can, but you can't puzzle with all this. I think sorting makes sense by this, and I will sort some varieties. I think I will sort this puzzle. It may not be necessary, but it will increase my joy. So I think I will sort it greater parts by color or by texture. So all these ceramics. This is one piece of this, but all the ceramics I think would take in one pile. It's not necessary to take it apart and say that's that. Some of the parts will be likely to be sorted, but here you have same bird on both on on the dishes. And it isn't necessary. You can sort this while I'm being puzzling, and the sugar on the tongue and the wooden table, the flowers and the greens and the lamp would be likely to be sorted, and maybe a little bit of the window also. And well, I think the metal tongue and the spoon, maybe, and the bell, maybe in one pile, and the books, maybe to the lamp, yes, and the vase to the flowers for the vase and separate pile. I think we'll sort the most of the parts by what I see. So the curtains are also a nice pattern. I've seen one or two. There's a window where the drops of water are leaning on, so like that. Over there. So let's sort. Some of them will be sewn in a miscellaneous pile, but I think I will sort them in brown piles and red piles and green piles, and yes, I think. But maybe they were a little bit on the bigger side, so so I have not so many piles. Sorting will take me a while, so enjoy, and
we see each other in the end of the video, so have a nice time lapse. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, hi to the resume. I will struggle a little with some words and some summaries and some vocabulary I didn't have, so it's always a little struggle to do this in English, but I will try. So, it's all blended, the colors didn't pop up, so it's really sometimes difficult to know where this piece goes. I mean, you have a piece in the hand and turn it this and that way and turn it and look, but I didn't see where this fits. To sort this in the first time, it was really difficult to sort, but my sort was accurate enough to put the puzzle together, and although it was difficult, it's really nice to see, like, I do it in sections, and it fits there, and goes up there, and then the edge comes in place, and I think the process of the puzzling shows what I mean when I say I didn't sort them accurate, but I have enough to puzzle with them. Also, the pieces are really unique, and though they are so tiny and the knobs not always so distinct, but they have a distinct form. So you can't, I didn't have much pieces where I put in a wrong piece in the wrong place, because they really have a good grid fit and a good piece shape. So it's not only the pattern, but here also I have two or three pieces I see they fit, but the pattern was so funny in the other side that I ever thought, could it be there? Is it right? Is the piece right here? But it was, and so the fit is really good, and the pieces shapes are unique enough to put it together. You can sort this by piece shape, and they have a really good variety. There are not so many standard pieces. They are really nice. I love when the pieces have not always standard shape. So they have really, really a big amount of other pieces. So it's really a nice amount, and you can puzzle with the shape also. It's just a really nice thing for this puzzle tube. So that's a really nice puzzle. I didn't have this brand since months ago. I ordered a package with new puzzles. I didn't know if I have this video on with the unboxing, so I explain it here also. So when you see the unboxing, ignore me. I've ordered a few puzzles of new brands, Cobble Hill, a Eurographic, and two Castorlands. That's the two. I didn't know if it's available in US or Canada or whatsoever, UK. The brand is from Europe, from Poland, and I've bought it on a website named Puzzle.at. AT stands for Austria, so it's a European site. I think it's a European puzzle seller. They sell not only in Austria, so in general in Europe. So they have European brands, but they also have the other brands, they imported them. So I always wanted a Cobble Hill, so I want particularly one Cobble Hill, and I have found a few others, and This was really, really cheap. It was 7 euros. And a lot of still lifes on Castorland have many puzzles with still lifes on it. So I decided to have a bigger one with 1,500 pieces, and the smaller one was cheap, and I really like this image, and I think I couldn't do wrong if I get for 500 pieces for 7 euros. So I think I grabbed this too, and I thought the quality couldn't be so bad that I regretted to buy it. So I bought it. And the piece size is really, really funny, because the piece size of the 500 pieces are regular sizes, so they feel really regular. And I love this, and I thought, yes, I must put this together and pack up the pieces. And the pieces are really, 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 really small. This is 84 centimeters by 68 centimeters. And this is 68 centimeters by 47. It's 1 centimeter off, smaller than the 1,000 pieces. With large piece account, the pieces were so small that the puzzle would be not so big. And I love the quality, though it's really thin and small pieces. It's a really nice puzzle, and I really think for this price, I love this brand. It didn't move either. It fits not tightly, crumbly on the crumbly side, but it's okay. I use Burger do this also. So all in all, I think it's a really nice brand and a really nice puzzle, and I recommend it. But if you're on the other side of the world, maybe it's difficult to get one of this. But I think it's a really nice brand. So let's say happy hobby allerseits und tschüss, bis zum nächsten Video. Ah, see you in the next, I say, but bis zum nächsten Video.